Hello students, in earlier video we had learned universal selector, okay? How to write the program with the help of universal selector and execution of the program of universal selector. Now in this video we will learn about here group selector, okay? What is meant by group selector? Okay, so we'll start here. The grouping selector is used to select all the elements with the same style definition. Means you want to select all the elements which is the what with the same style definition. Those elements are selected which includes the styling information which is common to all that elements. Okay. So next, it is used to minimize the code. Okay. Why it is used? Because to minimize the code. Okay. Next, commas are used to separate each separator in grouping. Okay. So how to write the exact code with the help of group selector? Now just observe here, CSS code without grouping. Okay. When we write the CSS code without a grouping, then what happens? Listen. Okay, this is for what? This is a H1 tag. It is the selector. Okay, text align center, then color is blue. Okay, then next is what? H2 selector, text align center, color is blue. Then third selector, that is H3, text align center and color is blue. Then fourth selector, that is P for paragraph, text align and center and the color is blue. Just observe here. All the properties and the all the value of that property are same in these four selectors. Okay, same. All properties and values are same. Okay, all properties and values are same here. But what we do here, you have to write separately. That is H1, write down separate for H2, then H3 and then P. Okay. Instead of this one, this is what? This is the what? Maximum code write down in your program. So to minimize this code, because the properties of, and the values of these four HTML elements are what? Same. So when we group this four selectors here and then write down the common in common text align center and color is blue, okay, then what happened? The code is minimized. Okay, so therefore we use here group selector. Okay, so how to write with the help of group selector? So CSS code with group selector with group, okay, that is H1, H2, H3, P, and this is separated by what? Commas, as we say earlier here. As I say earlier, commas are used to separate each selector in grouping. Commas are used. Okay, so when we separate these two HTML elements, then in between comma is used here. Correct. Then in bracket, write down the text align is center and color is blue. Okay, like this. This line shows what? That means this four line does the same work, and this one is line. This one line is also do the same work. Okay, that means here is what the work of these four lines, or the output of these four lines are same as of this line. Okay, that means this in this line the code is minimized. Okay, clear? Next. Next one example based on this one, that is group selector. Okay, so first tag, that is HTML tag, write down as it is, then head, then title, CSS group selector demo, and then close the title here. Then style, then use here what? Group selector. Group selector. Okay, H1, H2, comma, H3 and P. Okay, and write down the properties of this these what HTML elements, that is text align to center and color is blue. Then close the style tag and open body. So write down here h1 tag, write down here and type your CSS selector. H1 close, then h2 CSS group selector, then h2 is close here, then open the h3 CSS selector, CSS class selector, h3 is closed. Now next, open the p tag. These are only two types of selectors, and close this p tag, then close this body tag, and then close this HTML tag. Okay, so when this line executes, the control goes to where? H1. For H1 there are code is here, okay, as well as for H2 code is here. Next, for H3 also here, and then for P is also here. That means when execute these lines, these four lines, the text align with center and color is what? Blue of this text. So we will discuss this, or we will find out actual output of this program practically. So we will start this. Okay, we will start here how to create the program of group selector and the execution of the of this program. Okay, so first tag is what? HTML tag. Second, head, then title, that is CSS group selector demo, then close this title tag, then open style tag here, do not use upper left style tag, then use here the HTML elements that you want to style. Okay, that is, I want to here style the h1, h2, h3 and then p, and set here some properties like text align colon center semicolon color blue. Okay, next close this style tag, then open here, sorry, close the head tag here, then open body tag, set here background color, that is BG color, suppose yellow. Okay, next use here h1 tag. Okay, I want to write here some details, that is CSS group selector demo, then close here h1 tag. Next, open your h2 tag, and I want to write here some detail, that is CSS selectors, okay, selectors, and then close here h2 tag. Next, use here h3. I want to show you first selector, that is what? Suppose here ID selector, then close here H3, then use here P tag to show the next selector type, that is class selector, and then close here P. Another use here next P tag and show the third type,
that is group selector and close this tag data. Next, then close here. Suppose next tag use P, fourth one, that is universal selector. Then close this tag. Okay, next one, close the body tag and then close your HTML. HTML tag. Okay, then save this document. Okay, I want to save this document on desktop with the name group group selector dot html. Then save this. So on desktop one file is created, which is the group selector. So double click on it and see the output. So what you see here, just open our code file. Listen. Okay, listen here. First thing is what? Your main heading, that is H1, which shows what? CSS group selector. Then next, suppose I want to align these two left, or not align attributes, cancel out here. That means you can easily understand from this. Save this and refresh this. Okay, listen here. Okay, so first tag HTML. You listen, what is the title of your document? That is CSS group selector demo. Next thing is what? We have to apply one style. Styling or properties here, that is color is should be blue color within that HTML tag, that is H1, H2, H3, P. Means these HTML tags shows the properties like color is blue. That means whatever data write in H1 tag, H2 tag, H3 tag or P tag, the text should be in blue color. So all the text between these tags are shown in blue color in your output window. Suppose I want to change this, or I want to assign border here. So what is the border? That is suppose solid and width. Width attribute is used to assign the border with text only. Okay, colon, suppose here 200 pixels. Then what happened? Save this document and execute this. So the border is assigned only with the text. Okay, clear? Or if you want to, you have to change the pixel size, that is 400, then the border is border of each what information is changed according to that pixels. So here is that is 300 is okay. Now if you want to change the color, then border color, border color, then if it is red, then the border of the each and every HTML element is changed here. So save this document and execute this one. So border of the each element is changed here. Okay, clear? Next, if I don't want the changes, or if I don't want here H1, okay, that means the text be within that H1 do not apply any styling information. That means color it not shows the color in blue, border is not assigned to that. Okay, like this. That means the those information are grouped within the syntax or within the styling information, and that element only the style here. Okay, that means listen here. So you can easily distinguish that H1 is not belongs to this group, that is this one. H2, H3 and P only those elements which are right in style, right in what? Within the style, okay, or within the group, that element only apply this style on that text. Clear? So here H1 is not belongs to this one, select styling group. So therefore the all properties belonging to that group is are not applied to the H1 here. Clear? Suppose I want to use here another tag, that is which one? Suppose I want to use here H4 tag. Then what happen? H4. Okay, I want to write here these are types of CSS selectors, then close this H4 and save this. So H4 is not belongs to that group, so therefore these given properties are not applied to that HTML element. Okay, save this and see the output. Listen, so the output is shown like this. Okay, so this is the execution of the group selectors. Lastly, we can conclude here that group selectors are used to select some what grouping elements which you want to style. Okay, like in your example, what are the group elements here? That is H2, H3 and P only. Okay, if I want to add here H4 also, then what happened? The styling information is applied to H4 also here, then execute this one. That means the styling information is applied to on your the text like H4. Okay, clear? Understand this one? Very simple concept is there. So this is the your output of your group selector. Understand? So we will stop here. Thank you for watching. If you like this video, please share to your friends and subscribe my channel. Thank you.